Hi, it's Katrina. From mummified monsters to the world's largest collection of hair, here are 10 of the creepiest things found in museums. Number 10. Mummified clown. Mummies are popular exhibits in museums around the world, but there is one that's kept at the California Institute of Abnormal Arts that's unlike any you'll have ever seen before. Rather than being an ancient Egyptian pharaoh or an Incan priest, this one is the mummified remains of a clown. He was supposedly a performer named Achille Chatouilleux, who died in 1912. Prior to his death, he had asked that he be embalmed while in full costume and makeup, and he was placed inside a glass-topped coffin so he could be put on display. Like Snow White, but the creepy clown version. Of course, there have been questions about the authenticity of this creepy object, but tests have shown there to be high levels of arsenic and mercury, the chemicals used in the preservation process, and they date back to the correct time period. It's a frightening enough spectacle for people in the first place, let alone if you suffer from coulrophobia or the fear of clowns. Do you have this phobia? Let me know in the comments below. Clowns aren't my personal favorite thing, but I don't think I'm that scared of them, as long as I don't see one in an alley at night. This mummy has become one of the museum's most popular exhibits. Number 9. The Hollow Wheel. The Glore Psychiatric Museum in Missouri houses more than 10,000 different exhibits, most of which were collected by George Glore, who was an occupational therapist for a nearby hospital. He was fascinated by the history of early psychiatric treatments and created displays to show the various surgical tools, equipment, and techniques that were used over time. Suicide Squad, eat your heart out. There are lobotomy devices, re-education rooms, and examples of electric stimulation hardware used to rewire the brain. But one of the creepiest and most frightening exhibits is the Hollow Wheel. It's essentially like a giant hamster wheel, and patients were put inside for long periods of time in an attempt to help them forget the outside world and to focus just on one menial task. The museum also holds bloodletting tools, straitjackets, all kinds of restraints, and a lunatic box. Also called the English booth or the clock case, it was used in the 18th and 19th centuries. If a person was out of control, they would be locked in the pitch black box until they calmed down. I don't know about you, but it seems like all of this stuff would definitely make people worse. Besides the creepy surgical tools, equipment, and objects that were removed from patients, there is also patient artwork such as pottery, paintings, and needlework, giving you a glimpse inside their mind. The artwork speaks volumes about their pain and joy. Number 8. Plague mask. During this pandemic, we see medical staff in protective suits and people wearing all kinds of face masks in an attempt to limit the spread. This is not much different from what people used to do in the past. Throughout history, countless diseases have spread like wildfire through the human population, and medics had to make do with what they could. One of the creepiest objects that you can see in numerous museums is the plague mask. For a long time, no one really knew how the plague was transmitted. Perhaps foul air or bad winds, perhaps through eye contact or bad humors. They weren't that far off, really, since of course they didn't know what germs were yet. This mask from the Dutch History Museum represents the spooky outfits used while the bubonic plague raged. They were designed during the mass bubonic plague outbreaks in Europe, but it was not quite clear exactly when these bird doctor suits may have been used. Made from cotton, the mask was actually an entire hood with a beak. Inside, the beak held herbs or sponges soaked in vinegar or essential oils to ward off the smell. There were two small holes that were believed to filter the air and repel the disease. Of course, all of this really did was make the air smell nicer, but when they were working in environments that were full of dead and decomposing corpses, this would have been a welcome relief. The hood has glass lenses that cover the eyes to prevent patients from looking directly at the wearer in case the contagion could be transmitted by eye contact. The rest of the suit was a type of leather cloak that could cover the entire body, forming a protective suit similar to those used today. While these masks have become an iconic symbol of the Black Death, its invention is attributed to a French doctor named Charles Delorme in 1619. He designed this mask and cloak based on soldiers' armor, which was a perfect comparison as every day they were going into battle against this mysterious disease, just like today. And now for number 7, but first, big shout out to Stephanie Hoff and Caleb Michael. Thanks so much for supporting this channel. If you are new here, be sure to subscribe if you haven't already, and let me know which one you think is the creepiest in the comments below. Number 7. Child's skull. When we're a child, we grow our first set of teeth, which as we grow up, fall out and are replaced with our stronger adult's teeth. But these replacements don't actually grow when they're needed, but are instead present in our skulls all along. Did you know that? Pretty bizarre, right? I guess unless you're a dentist. To show this, the Mutter Museum at the College of Physicians in Philadelphia has got a pretty gruesome exhibit to show us what we actually look like underneath all of our tissue and soft bits. This skull has been carefully cut by an anatomist to show the skull that at first glance seems like any other, but look closer around the mouth. You'll see that the child's teeth are there, and right above them, the adult teeth are also there, waiting above and below the infant's teeth, ready to take their place. It's fascinating to see from a biological perspective, but it's almost impossible to not be creeped out by this macabre object. Number 6. Jar of moles. Moles are subterranean animals that are perfectly adapted to spending most of their lives digging through the ground, and because we rarely see them on the surface, they have long been a source of curiosity. It's no surprise then that they are often put on display at zoos and collected and exhibited at museums, but there is a mole display at the Grant Museum of Zoology in London that is just downright bizarre. It's a jar that's stuffed full of 18 moles. In fact, they have several jars of moles like this, and there are a few reasons why they may have been prepared and preserved in this way. The first is that storing animals used to be an extremely expensive process, and by keeping multiple specimens together, you don't need as many glass jars and can use far less embalming fluid. It's easier to transport them too, and it's quite possible these were never meant for display, and were instead destined for student dissection classes with a mole for each student. Whatever the reason, it certainly makes for one of the most unique and strange exhibits you'll ever see, and is surely the stuff of nightmares. Number 5. Locks of hair. There is a small town in Turkey called Avanos, and it's a place that's long been of interest to archaeologists because of its rich history. Countless shards of pottery and other ceramics have been found in the area that date back thousands of years. But some people who lived there decided that it was time to create a new modern-day attraction to lure tourists to the region. So the story goes, this new museum was set up by a potter in 1979, who was devastated that a good friend of his was leaving, so he asked her for a lock of her hair to remember her by. He displayed it in his store as a talking piece, and over the years, other women also made a donation. Now the store has dedicated a passageway to the objects and has had more than 16,000 locks of donated hair. They are attached to every surface, and the venue holds the world record for the largest such collection. Only women are allowed to donate, but there is something in it for them too. Every year, a few of the locks are chosen as winners, and those who gave them to the museum are invited to return to stay at a local guest house where they're given complimentary pottery lessons. Hair everywhere! I know it was donated, but still, no thanks. Number 4. The Dusseldorf Vampire. Whether or not you believe vampires truly exist, there are certainly some people who have had a strange obsession with blood, and one of the most notorious in history was Peter Curtin. During his reign of terror almost 100 years ago, he killed at least 9 people, severely injured many others, and did this just so he could drain their veins for his own gratification. He soon became known as the Dusseldorf Vampire, and after making a mistake, he was caught and beheaded in 1931. Authorities and scientists couldn't understand why someone would develop such a horrific habit, so they theorized that there was something wrong with the way his brain had developed. They took his detached head and cut it open to see, but to their horror, there was nothing abnormal about it at all. However, instead of disposing of it or burying it, they preserved the specimen, and it can now be seen hanging from a rotating hook at the Ripley's Believe It or Not Museum in Wisconsin Dells. Number 3. Musée du Poitrin. Opened in a disused part of a convent by French chemist Mathieu Orfila in 1835, the Musée du Poitrin is a massive collection of anatomical pieces that depict various diseases. There are real, preserved specimens as well as wax replicas, and it's an invaluable resource for medics learning about the pathology of illnesses. The Parisian Museum also happens to be one of the creepiest museums in the world. Amongst the thousands of objects on display are conjoined twins, preserved brains of aphasic patients, specimens with congenital deformities, examples of parasites that live in the human body, and perhaps most gruesomely, depictions of all known sexually transmitted diseases. Due to the fragility of the exhibits, the museum strictly limits who is able to take a look around, but with such a wealth of art in the city, it's hardly at the top of many people's to-do list. Number 2. Fiji Mermaid. Mermaids are mythical creatures that have been told about ever since people first set sail on the seas, but with so little of the oceans having been fully explored, actual evidence of their existence has yet to be discovered. This didn't stop showmen in the 19th century from showcasing mermaid exhibits. But instead of being the real deal, they were creative works made by combining the remains of other animals. They may sort of be mermaids, but they were pretty ugly. P.T. Barnum was one of the most well-known exhibitors of these so-called Fiji mermaids after opening his American Museum in New York City in 1842. People came from far and wide to see this marvel of so-called nature. The famous Fiji mermaid had the head of an orangutan and the tail of a salmon. The mermaid was most likely created by a Japanese fisherman, although others believe that these types of figures were used in some religious practices. Story goes that a Dutch merchant purchased this mermaid in 1810, as the Dutch were the only people allowed to trade with Japan. When trade routes opened up, many more fake mermaids started to appear in Europe. The Dutch ship sank, but everyone, including the mermaid, was rescued by an American captain who was so fascinated by it that he sold his ship and bought it from the Dutch merchant for $6,000. To make his money back, he started charging people to see it and made enough money to make his way to London. He seems to have believed that the mermaid was actually real, and many publications backed him up. It made for a pretty convincing exhibit back then, but surely no one would fall for it these days, would they? Number 1. The Museum of Death. Humans have an undeniable fascination with the creepy, but there is one place that trumps them all when it comes to spooky exhibits. They also have the head of notorious French mass murderer Henri Landru and a suicide machine called Thanatron that was built by Dr. Jack Kevorkian, a leading campaigner of assisted suicide. Unsurprisingly, the museum has attracted criticism over the years, particularly by their landlords in San Diego, who evicted them and were accused of acting in bad taste when they tried to acquire an electric chair in 2008. They like to toe the line and see just how far they can go. They also hold a yearly competition where entrants are encouraged to dress up as either a pre- or post-mortem Black Dahlia, something that continues to make headlines because of its seeming lack of respect to the dead. However, if you're curious about this kind of thing, then there's no better place than the Museum of Death. But be warned, it's undoubtedly the creepiest museum in the world, and virtually every exhibit will send chills down your spine. Thanks for watching! Hope you didn't watch this right before bedtime! What did you think was the creepiest? Let me know in the comments below, and be sure to subscribe if you are new here! Sweet dreams! Bye!